Court rules can sometimes require some of the craziest page numbering schemes imaginable. We'll talk about how you can meet those requirements coming up. Hi, I'm Deborah Saavedra with Legal Office Guru, your resource for legal professionals using Microsoft Office. And in today's video, I'm going to show you how to embed some of the more creative page numbering schemes courts sometimes come up with. If you've seen my previous video on how to control page numbering by document section, you've seen that it's possible to restart your page numbering at the beginning of each section. But what if your court's rules include a page X of Y requirement, or if other text needs to be embedded in the page numbering block in specific sections of your document? For example, the 11th Circuit Court of Appeals requires the page numbering for the Certificate of Interested Persons section of an appellate brief have a C dash in front of the current page number, followed by space of space, and the total number of pages in that specific section. How do you do that? The secret to pulling off any sort of page X of Y numbering scheme is in using fields. Even when you insert the current page number, you're using something Word calls a field. It's a self-calculating bit of code that performs a particular function. Word has a whole slew of them for all sorts of functions, but the ones we're going to review are page, numpages, and section pages. All fields are accessible from the Insert tab under Quick Parts, Field. That brings up the Field dialog box. If you have All listed under Categories, you'll see an alphabetical list of fields underneath. You can use the Categories drop-down to limit the list to certain categories, but unfortunately the three fields we'll examine today don't all appear in one specific category. First, let's reconstruct the page X of Y footer we saw earlier. This will be comprised of two different fields. X will be the current page number and uses the field page. Y will be the total number of page numbers in the entire document and will use the field numpages. So I'm going to go back to my footer and type page space, then embed my first page numbering field. I'll go to the Insert tab, Quick Parts, Field, then under Categories All, I'm going to scroll down and find the Page field. I'm going to select that, and you notice that some of the formatting options appear on the right. I'm going to select Arabic numerals and click OK to finish. And that embeds that after the word page. Now I'm going to type space of space and embed the second field that signifies the total number of pages in the document. It's the same operation, just a different field. Insert, Quick Parts, Field, but this time I'm going to find numpages. Again, when I select this field, some of the formatting options appear on the right. I'll select Arabic numerals and click OK to finish. So that's the page X of Y footer. The difference between that and the C1 of 2 footer is that the latter page number represents the total number of pages in that section. This is what you'd use if your document had multiple sections. In other words, you have section breaks separating the document into different sections, like when you separate your table of contents from the main body of your document and want to number them independently. So I can start by typing C dash, and as before, I'm going to go to the Insert tab, Quick Parts, Field, and selecting the Page field, just as before. Then I type space of space to insert the total number of pages in this section. Again, Insert tab, Quick Parts, Field, and this time I'm selecting Section Pages. That's the one difference between this example and the last, because this field shows the total number of pages in this section. By the way, don't think you're stuck having to do this every single time you want to embed one of these page numbering schemes into your document. You can save these to use later using a feature called Quick Parts. I'll put a link up above and in the description below to a tutorial showing how to save any text snippet, even those with fields embedded, as a Quick Part for future use. Hey, if this video has helped you, be sure to subscribe to this channel and hit the notification bell so you won't miss new videos in this series. And if you're in the middle of writing a brief, you're probably including a table of authorities, which can be a bona fide minefield. Let me help. Download my free Table of Authorities pre-published checklist, which shows you the 10 most common problems you'll run into with TOA, with links to helpful articles and videos on how to fix them, to make sure yours is up to standards before you print or PDF your next brief. Click on the link above or in the description below and download your checklist today.